നല്ല ഒന്നാന്തരം കുറച്ച് സെൻ ബുദ്ധിസ്റ്റ് കഥകളാണ് ഈ വീഡിയോയിൽ അവതരിപ്പിക്കുന്നത്. ഈ വീഡിയോ കാണുന്നതുകൊണ്ട് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഇതിൽ പറയുന്ന കഥകൾ കേൾക്കുന്നതുകൊണ്ട് നിങ്ങൾക്ക് രണ്ട് പ്രയോജനങ്ങളുണ്ടാവും. ഒന്നാമതായി, ഇംഗ്ലീഷിലാണ് ഞാൻ ഈ കഥകൾ അവതരിപ്പിക്കുന്നത്. അതുകൊണ്ട് തന്നെ കുറച്ച് നേരം ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് കേട്ട് ലിസണിങ് സ്കിൽസ് ഇമ്പ്രൂവ് ചെയ്യാൻ ഈ വീഡിയോ നിങ്ങളെ സഹായിക്കും. കുട്ടികൾക്കും വളരെ ഉപകാരപ്രദമായിരിക്കും അത്, കാരണം നമ്മുടെ ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് നിലവാരം വർദ്ധിപ്പിക്കാൻ ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് നന്നായിട്ട് കേൾക്കുന്നത് ബെസ്റ്റാണ്. രണ്ടാമതായി, സന്ദർഭത്തിനനുസരിച്ച് പ്രസംഗങ്ങളിലോ ക്ലാസ്സുകളിലോ ഇനി വല്ല ലേഖനങ്ങളിലോ ഒക്കെ ഉപയോഗിക്കാൻ പറ്റിയ നല്ല കുറച്ച് കഥകൾ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് കിട്ടും. അത് സൂപ്പറല്ലേ? മനസ്സ് വച്ചാൽ നിങ്ങൾക്കൊരു രവി പത്മനാഭൻ ലെവലിലൊക്കെ എത്താം. എല്ലാ കഥയും കേൾക്കുന്നതിനൊപ്പം സ്ക്രീനിൽ വായിക്കുകയും ചെയ്യാം. അല്പം കട്ടിയായ വാക്കുകളും അവയുടെ അർത്ഥങ്ങളും പ്രത്യേകം എഴുതി കാണിക്കുകയും ചെയ്യാം. അപ്പോൾ നമുക്ക് കഥ കേട്ട് തുടങ്ങാം. ഈ കഥകൾ ഇഷ്ടപ്പെടുകയാണെങ്കിൽ ചാനൽ സബ്സ്ക്രൈബ് ചെയ്യുന്ന കാര്യം പരിഗണിക്കുമെന്ന് വിശ്വസിക്കുന്നു.
A group of frogs were traveling through the woods when two of them fell into a deep pit. All the other frogs gathered around the pit. When they saw how deep it was, they told the two frogs that they were as good as dead. The two frogs ignored the comments and tried to jump out of the pit with all their might. The other frogs kept telling them to stop, that they were as good as dead. Finally, one of the frogs took heed to what the other frogs were saying and gave up. She fell down and died. The other frog continued to jump as hard as she could. Once again, the crowd of frogs yelled at her to stop the pain and just die. She began jumping even harder and finally made it out. When she got out, the other frog said, "Did you not hear us?" The frog explained to them that she was deaf. She thought that they were encouraging her to jump out of the hole the entire time. When the spiritual teacher and his disciples began their evening meditation, the cat who lived in the monastery made such a noise that it distracted them. So the teacher ordered that the cat be tied up during the evening practice. Years later, when the teacher died, the cat continued to be tied up during the meditation session. And when the cat eventually died, another cat was brought to the monastery and tied up. Centuries later, learned descendants of the spiritual teacher wrote scholarly treatises about the religious significance of tying up a cat for a meditation practice. Two monks were washing their bowls in the river when they noticed a scorpion that was drowning. One monk immediately scooped it up and set it up on the bank. In the process, he was stung. He went back to washing his bowl and again the scorpion fell in. The monk saved the scorpion and was again stung. The other monk asked him, "Friend, why do you continue to save the scorpion when you know its nature is to sting?" "Because," the monk replied, "to save, it is my nature." A little bear cub was confused about how to walk. "What do I do first, Ma?" he asked his mother. "Do I start with my right foot or my left, or both front feet and then my back feet? Or do I move both feet on one side and then both feet on the other?" His mother answered, "Just quit thinking and start walking." Four monks decided to meditate silently without speaking for 2 weeks. By nightfall, on the first day, the candle began to flicker and then went out. The first monk said, "Oh no, the candle is out." The second monk said, "Aren't we not supposed to talk?" The third monk said, "Why must you break the silence?" The fourth monk said, "Huh, I'm the only one who didn't speak." Tansen and Ikido were once traveling together down a muddy road. A heavy rain was still falling. Coming around a bend, they met a lovely girl in a silk kimono and sash, unable to cross the intersection. "Come on, girl," said Tansen at once. Lifting her in his arms, he carried her over the mud. Ikido did not speak again until that night when they reached a lodging temple. Then he no longer could restrain himself. "We monks don't do near females," he told Tansen. "Especially not young and lovely ones. It is dangerous. Why did you do that?"
"I left the girl there," said Tansen.
"Are you still carrying her?"